Hello everybody and welcome back to Knavesville Farm Extended. So, we're here in the Fendt 820 and this isn't the tractor which is going to be replaced. We are going to replace one tomorrow and I think the most suggested tractor to change was the Big John Deere. Now, there is a possibility of all you massive John Deere fans out there to suddenly react to that and say, no, don't do that to the John Deere. Well, it does have, I think it was the sound, it was very loud. So that is one reason why I'm sort of for that decision. It just depends. But yeah, it's looking likely that it will be the John Deere, whatever it is. What is it? Can't remember. That's another reason. I can't remember its model number. It's a bad reason as to why to get rid of it, but yeah, I think that is the one that's most requested, so that would be going tomorrow. Anyway, today what we're going to do is first of all take this back to the yard because I need to replace this trailer with a trailer which is either from the base game or a modded trailer which uses the base game trailer script. I've been told this by the creator of the map that that's what you need to be able to load up the dried grain, so that is what we're going to do. Oh, there's that fly again. So many people say, why do you have flies in your room and stuff? Don't worry, I'm not that dirty. It is, it's a fly in the game. I think it's around a pond or something there. So that is the reason for the buzzing sound. But when we've dropped this off, I'm going to get a different trailer. Apparently, the Marston trailer, or the AS trailer, is a compatible trailer with this mod. So we might go for that, although we do have that trailer already on Thornton Farm. We could get the dump trailer version though. Might not be a bad idea, because we're going to have sugar beet at some point. Quite a good trailer for sugar beet. Right, here we are. And this week also, probably today actually, we're going to tidy up the yard just in there, to the right of us now. Right, come on, let's get this thing reversed. Not always easy, especially in a bigger tractor. Seems to be okay. Right, straighten up and we'll drop it off. There we go. Okay, so over to the shop. We'll buy the dump trailer, Marston trailer, and we will get that dried grain sold. Looking forward to it because I want to know exactly how much more money we can get for it. It probably does say on the info page. Also, I've just adjusted the degrees of rotation on my steering wheel so it should look a bit smoother. Hopefully. Right, so this trailer is in tippers and somewhere in here we've got it. I don't know if the Roland one is compatible. I don't think it is. Stuart one as well. So, yeah, I don't know. Would it be? I don't know. Would it be just this one? Or would this one work as well? I wonder if they've got the same script. I might play it safe and go for this one. Because I don't want to buy it and find out that it's not the right trailer. Right, I think this one here is the Marston Blue. That's the default colour at least. So we'll go with that. Get a hitch onto the back. I did consider changing the 820, this tractor, but then it's been so handy recently. I think it would be a shame. Put the beacon back on. I do actually have the mod installed which keeps the beacon going when you get out of the cab, but that is a... Well, it seems to be very temperamental. Sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. It might depend on the type of tractor. Pretty sure it does work perfectly with the base game tractors. Something else I mustn't forget about is tedding field number 78. That needs to be done as a priority. We need to create the hay bales. Another thing is recently, I think it was about a week ago, there was a new mod released. Buyable bales. This is available on FSUK And I like the idea of it, because obviously these really small farms, which can't afford to run the machinery to create bales themselves, or don't need that many bales, can then go and buy the bales themselves, what they need, from a different farmer. And I think that is a really good idea. So we might even use that mod on here, because if you don't necessarily, for example, a livestock farm, you don't have a combine, so you're not going to be able to create the straw, then being able to buy it without buying a combine is brilliant. And the baler. Oh yes, we have got this raised up bit here. The ramp does go uphill, so you've got to sort of floor it or put forward drive on everything, diff lock. I think it's the shoe of the trailer, designed to drive in the other way. But I'm just trying to make life hard here. So, let's hope this is going to work. Please do work. Please. Now, upon further examination, we only have 69% of dry grain. I wonder if you have to totally fill the dryer before you can unload it. That might not be the case, but it is a possibility. I hate to give up so easily, but as I can't see any grain in here anymore, which is a bit weird, then you might have to. It is showing 69% of dry grain, so we definitely have some, but yeah, clearly the chute is coming out of the dryer and you can't see anything in there, so yes, I'm guessing that is the issue. But it's okay for today, because what we're going to do is turn the tractor off here. I'll do a bit more research into it later on. And we're going to go off in a different tractor. I suppose we could even go in the Axos. Oh yeah, a lot of people did say get rid of the Axos as well. I quite like it. Although it's not very detailed, in its own way, it's nice. I should think in real life, they're brilliant. So we'll take that off there, and we're going to go over to the main yard once again. Unless I think I did actually. Did I take... Oh, I'm doing too many things at once here. Dried grain, is that on here? It is. Price is... Oh, whoa, look at the pigs. Look at the price of the pigs, that is crazy. No way is that right. Right, dry grain is £5,271 per tonne. That is worth it, definitely. I think this was only wheat, wasn't it? Or barley I put in here. And yeah, wheat. And look at the difference. 5,271 compared to, just go up. Wheat is here. 594. Wow. What a difference. So when we do actually manage to get it into the trailer, which seems to be proving quite difficult, then we're going to be rich. And I can't wait for it. So that'll probably be tomorrow, next day, who knows? As soon as I find out exactly how to load it up. If we do have to do another wheat harvest though, then it'll be a little bit longer. I've just looked into where the tedder is, and we did indeed take it over here. I should have remembered that, but it is down here. Good size for the tractor as well. It's a very small field, field number 78, so this is going to take next to no time. And I believe field 77 also does need to be picked up with the forager. Okay, here we are. So where did I put it? My guess is either round there or over here. No, not through there. Must be back here. We did put some stuff over here. We will reverse in. Yes, this is the tractor. Here it is. Yeah, the 7810. I quite like it. But it's not the best tractor in the world. But it's certainly not the worst. Nice to have it on the farm. Or it was nice to have it on the farm, I should say. We probably will have it again in a future series. But yeah, that is the most requested tractor to replace, so I guess it will be. I might get a Case, actually, a Case IH. That would go down very well. I know my audience does like Case, and I don't use them very often. So that could be a very good brand to go for. Let's just get this done really quickly. Yep, that needs to be done. So as you can see, tiny field, just enough to create a good number of hay bales for us. The livestock do need it. So the handy thing about this is you can turn certain degrees with the tether on the ground, because I think it sort of floats behind you. And I would say that is the best sized tractor you could possibly put on this tether. That is why I'm keeping the Axos, because it is so handy. I can remember when FS17 was sort of in its heyday, there was a class pack released, very highly detailed for the time, and yeah, it was so highly requested and highly anticipated and everything. And I don't think any class packs have been released really for FS15. There's been converted ones from previous versions, but I don't think there's been any made from scratch, any really high quality ones. There was the class Axion, that was decent. But other than that, I think it's, yeah, not many. It's a bit of a shame, really. There we go, the famous square we're being left with as usual. What comes down to the shape of the field, I think, in the first place. If you haven't got a square field, you kind of get the square, the triangle. There we go, that's the shapes being mixed up. And that is us done. So what we need to do now is take this back over to the yard behind us. We'll fold it up obviously and switch it all off. There we go. Yeah, when you switch it off you sort of get a bald patch because it flicks it behind it. Go in here. I think actually if this tractor had working mirrors it would add an awful lot to it. It's a shame it doesn't. It probably wouldn't be too hard for a modder to do that. But the hour meter is what I love. We've done 2 hours so far, real time. Some seed bags here. Here we go. Right, so instead of using the forager, whoa, I was lowering that to get it in, but then it goes and slides off. There we go. I was going to say, instead of using the forager, we could use the forage wagon just here to pick up the grass in field 77. But we'll see. We might not do it today, because what I did want to do was check on the animals, because they do need to be looked after. It gets me every time this turning. I always think, oh, let's just swing over there, but it's actually a very tight turn just around the corner. Yeah, I think we're done here for today. So we'll head back, and tomorrow we'll probably row that up and sort out field 77 as well. Stay on the road. As for forestry on this map, we're going to do forestry on Thornton Farm, so it won't be just yet, but at some point in the future, probably end of October, we will definitely do an episode of forestry. Yes, that is soil mod gone. I think it's because I put it back for Thornton Farm, so it's returned for Knavesville. So I've just had to get rid of it again. But it shouldn't reappear, hopefully. And this tractor should be brilliant for doing the yard shunting, which we're about to do in a minute or two. We are going to check the info page just to make sure the animals are doing okay. The last thing we want them to do is die. That would be terrible. I'm not 100% sure, but I think the pigs... Is it pigs on this map? I don't think it is, actually. No, it's the lambs. I think they can possibly die. I've had them disappear before, so I don't know if that's sort of a glitch or they actually are dying, but yeah, certainly these ones can't die, no way. But just sort of flicking through here, the cows do need feed and they need water, but yeah, otherwise they are okay. They've got straw. I don't know why it's disappeared, because I did this last week. It must be something to do with soil mod, I'm guessing. Don't see why it would affect it, but That's all I can think of. And yeah, we haven't done these at all yet, so that is for a future video. So the priority for this week is certainly to feed the cows. They're desperate. They are in a field, so they've got grass on the ground, but I don't think it sort of recognises that as a source of feed. The sheep wool pallet is also full, so that'll need to be moved. I have to write these things down so I remember. But yeah, as a priority, let's just get this yard cleaned up. It does need to be done. Right, so we've got a random trailer just here, parked in a silage pit. That's okay, it can go in the silage pit because we don't need it. So, straight to the back. It can stay there, but if you go too far actually, yes, it doesn't let you. I can see why now. So we'll put it in this bay over here, in front of the fertiliser spreader. Easy enough to get out again if we need to. There we go. Next we've got a seed drill, quite a big one too. And this can go in the middle bay. The idea here is to pretty much pack them full, get as much in there as we can do, because I very easily run out of space. There we go. And finally, the conveyor, which needs to be pulled from the other side. But yeah, I don't know where we're going to put it. I think we might actually have to just swing it around into the bay next to us. Because it's not a trailer, it shouldn't stop us. It's when it flashes up with the tipping trigger that it doesn't let you do this. But the conveyor should be fine. It's where it needs to be anyway. This is where we use it. So just there should be perfectly adequate. So that's sort of tidied this yard up. We'll move up here. How much space do we have? We have got, well, quite a lot of space really. We're doing okay. I think there is a trailer down here. Yeah, it's just a slurry tank. The slurry tank is, well, it sort of moved in a peculiar way. I think it was my drunk parking. Well, we're sort of playing drunk. I wasn't drunk. But it needs to be moved. So we'll put that back in its position. We are gaining slurry, that's good. But we're a long way off from a tank full. Put it here. There we go. Yes, it is out of scale, the Red Rock slurry spreader. But it doesn't really matter. So that can stay there. So the final yard we do need to clear up is, well, the final field we need to clear up is this one here. What is the Pottinger Mech 6? It keeps flashing up and I've looked and I can't work out what it is. I don't know if it's got like a different store name or something to what it actually is. Got to go through at an angle, otherwise we can't get out. Now this will probably be best suited in the yard to the right hand side. But it will be quite hard to get it in there. As you can see, it is a very narrow entrance, so let's try my best. There we go, just about. So that can go in here. It always looks a lot better when you tidy a yard up. Looks terrible if it's all scruffy, which is what it's usually like. So there we go, that is that done. The lorry, I think one person said to sell it, so that's obviously not enough to go by. We'll keep it for the time being. It's very handy to have, so I can't really see the need in getting rid of it. But really, this is the best place for it. So if we just neaten it up a little bit, then we'll keep it here. Bit of a bush push. We've got a back window. And we've got cameras. There we go. Brilliant. So we'll park it here. Fantastic. Finally, we have got a big bag which doesn't need to be here at all because it's probably been used. I don't know if it has. No. I think if it had been used, it would be flat, but we don't need it. When we need to use some, we'll just buy some more. We'll get rid of it. We actually have 4 of the seed bags. And we have 2 of the fertilizer bags. It's just so much easier to get them from the store though. So the final thing is the fuel bowser. That was supposed to stay on the Axos, but obviously I've taken it off. So we'll get that back, get it moved. And that, I think, will be the cleaning up process done. Very, very muddy around here. Squeeze through the gap. Go through here. And yeah, the best place for it is actually where the fuel tank is. Keeps it out of the way. Otherwise, we'll just be blocking in other tractors in the yard. There we go. So that is looking much neater. I do get criticised quite a bit for the tidiness of my yard, and it tends to be terrible. So hopefully now that is a lot better. That wall pallet there does not look full. It's got like 3 sacks on it, so why it's showing 100%, I'm not too sure. There we go. Right, so we're done. Yeah, it's 100% apparently this. I find it hard to believe, but it is. It says 100%, so we can't really argue. That does need to be moved. Is that our pallet? Yes, it is. So where is the telehandler? Where did I put it? Not here. Here we are in the telehandler. We'll be using it to do the bales, so I had to bring it back from near the yard. We should be able to just about squeeze in here. There we go. And we're not really going to put this anywhere in particular. We just need to get off the trigger, because otherwise the next stack won't spawn. And now we've put the axles there, it makes it very difficult. Great planning. Right, under there, lift up, bring forwards a bit, lower it down again, and yeah, we should be able to pick it up a bit better now. So the sheep wool is still showing 100%, so maybe the trigger has moved, because I think the sheep have moved. I should do, just for the purpose of moving this. We're going to put it down here. We have another full pallet in here. Yeah, not sure what that's about. Still showing 100%, so I have no idea. There we go. So that, I think, is actually it for today. Nothing else that I wanted to do. Tomorrow we've got a lot to do, so stay tuned. But yeah, we're going to leave it there. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope you join me again in the next episode. Until then, see you again soon. Bye for now.